Hello, my name is Heidi J. Smith, Chief of Operations for the Division of Medical Assistance and Health Services, New Jersey Department of Human Services. This training is on the NJ FamilyCare Aged, Blind, Disabled Programs online application, otherwise known as the ABD online application. Let's get started going over the features of the new ABD online application. The online ABD application can be accessed from the ABD page of the Division of Medical Assistance and Health Services website. Someone may also access the ABD online application by visiting njhelps.org and screening for assistance programs. Applicants must register and create an account. By creating an account, the applicant will not be required to complete an application in one sitting. They will be able to save the application in progress and log into their account later to continue the application where they left off. You must complete the page before you will be allowed to save it. With this online application, the applicant has the ability to attach any necessary documents. Documents may be uploaded at the end of their online application. The applicant will be able to log into their account and upload or attach their documents at a later time. Eventually, they will also be able to log into their account and look at any of the letters that was sent to them. Click Start a New Application. Answer the basic screening questions. Depending on the answers, the applicants will be directed to the ABD application, the NJ FamilyCare application, or the Federal Marketplace for more information and to apply. This page shows that based on the answers to the screening questions, the applicant will be directed to the ABD application. See the name of the program in the blue bar at the top of the page. A screening results page indicating a different program will have information relating to that program. All online applicants must agree to the privacy policy in order to continue with the online application. If they disagree, they will not be able to continue with the online application. All online applicants must agree to estate recovery acknowledgement in order to continue with the online application. If they disagree, they will not be able to continue with the online application. In essence, the state must claim funds from a deceased NJ FamilyCare beneficiary's estate as reimbursement for the benefits provided after the person turned 55. The state must be reimbursed before any inheritance can take place. Applicants must register and create an account in order to apply online for ABD. If they cannot create an account because they do not have an email address, they will have to submit a paper application. After the applicant enters their name and email, click Send Confirmation Email. The next several screenshots are about registering for an NJ FamilyCare ABD account. This page appears saying the confirmation email has been sent. At this point, the applicant must access their email to finish registering their account so they can continue the online application. This is an example of the confirmation email that will be sent to an applicant. Click the link to confirm the email address. Please note that the text of the link will be different for each person. After clicking the link in the confirmation email, this page comes up in the internet browser. Choose a password that is at least 10 characters long and includes at least one letter and one number. Type it in the password and confirm the password fields. This means type the same thing in both boxes. Click the box in front of "I'm not a robot" to proceed with the CAPTCHA task that verifies that a human being is actually completing this application. Follow the instructions that pop up. This will be different every time. If you would like a different task, click the round refresh arrow at the bottom left corner of the box. After completing the task, click Verify. This process may have to be repeated. When the green check appears to the left of I'm not a robot, click Complete Registration. And now that the registration is complete, the applicant will be directed to the first page of the application. So let's get started. First, enter household information. At the top of this page in yellow, it gives directions for how to complete this page. The person who is applying for ABD should enter their information on the first line. A spouse or any other family member living in the household should be entered on this page. By clicking Add to Household, a new row will be added to the table so they can enter another person's information. Note that at this time, only one person can apply for ABD through this online application. If their spouse or another family member also wants to apply for ABD, they will need to complete a separate online application. Click Save and Next to go to the next page. The address page is for the contact information of the applicant. Only the applicant's contact information should be entered on this page. Home and mailing address are required. If the mailing address is the same, they can check the box to indicate that. The applicant must answer if they have lived somewhere else in the past 5 years. If they have, a table will appear for them to enter the previous address or addresses. The application will automatically verify the address that has been entered. A small mistake in the address might be automatically corrected. This example shows that the zip code was changed from 08610 to 08611. The automatic address verification feature will help cut down on returned mail due to a poor address being entered. Sometimes during address verification, the applicant will be prompted to choose the correct address. The window shows the addresses with various house numbers and zip codes. Scroll down to see more addresses if necessary. If the applicant's address is shown in the list, they should check the box next to it and click Submit. If their address falls in a range, they should check the box next to the range. Enter the house number or apartment number unit in the box on the right, then click Submit. Once the message appears that the address is verified, the applicant can continue with the application. Click Save and Next. The information for the applicant page shows the applicant's name at the top. Depending on how the applicant answers, certain questions, additional questions, may appear. The applicant should provide their Social Security number. It is required if they are eligible for the program. If the applicant entered a spouse on the household page, then number 10 marital status is automatically set to married, and it will add extra questions about the spouse. Different questions may appear under number 10 if the marital status is different. If a person is incapable of following up on their application, they may need someone to speak with the CWA regarding their application and their eligibility. They will need to enter that person's information under Assistance with Application. If the person will be the authorized representative, the designation of an authorized representative form will appear. The applicant must print the form, complete it, and then upload that in the attachments page. If the applicant wishes to be represented by their power of attorney or perhaps their legal guardian, they will be prompted to upload those documents on the attachment page. The applicant's health insurance information is also entered on this page. If they answer yes to number 13 about Medicare, then a table will appear so they can enter their Medicare policy information. If they answer yes to number 14, other health insurance, another table would appear so that they can enter that policy information. If they have long-term care insurance or long-term care partnership policy approved by New Jersey Department of Banking and Insurance, they will be prompted to upload that document on the attachment page. The applicant must specify their living arrangements. Check all the options that apply, such as home and they own it, or living with spouse. Then click Save and Next. Income information of the applicant must be entered. Income is reported as gross income. Under employment status, the applicant can indicate if they are employed or self-employed. More questions will appear based on what they choose. If they are not employed at all, they would check the box to indicate no work income. The applicant must indicate the types of other income they received, how much they received, and how often they receive it. The yearly income question only needs to be completed if the applicant expects their income to change from month to month. If they do not expect their monthly income to change, they can check the box to indicate that. If the applicant has a spouse, the spouse's income information must also be entered. Even if the spouse is not applying for ABD, their income information is still needed in order to determine the applicant's eligibility. On this example, the applicant must have indicated a spouse named Maria DiLorenzo. So now her income needs to be reported. The applicant must answer as much as they can regarding their spouse's income, though this may be difficult if they are separated. Under employment status, the applicant can indicate if their spouse is employed or self-employed. More questions will appear based on what they choose. If they are not employed at all, they would check the box to indicate no work income. The applicant must indicate the types of other income their spouse receives, how much they receive, and how often they receive it. The yearly income question only needs to be completed if the spouse expects their income to change from month to month. If they do not expect their monthly income to change, they can check the box to indicate that. Resources. This page asks for the resources of the applicant and their spouse. Even if the spouse is not applying for ABD, information about their resource information is still needed to determine the applicant's eligibility. The applicant must answer as much as they can regarding their spouse's resources, though this may be difficult if they are separated. The applicant must declare any cash on hand and list their resources beginning with any accounts. Note that information for resources held within 60 months of the date of the application must be declared. Investments must also be entered. The applicant can check the box to indicate no investments. The applicant must list any properties they own. Life insurance policies must also be entered. The applicant should be sure to answer whether they have knowledge of being named a beneficiary on someone else's policy. And vehicles owned must also be declared. Under trust, the applicant can note if they have a testamentary trust, a special needs trust, or a qualified income trust. The applicant must also note any burial arrangements. If they select yes for the prepaid burial contract question or the burial arrangement or contract through a life insurance policy question, then they will be prompted to upload that document on the attachments page. Any other resources that were not already listed in this section can be listed under Other Resources Not Listed. The applicant must note if they plan to liquidate any of their resources. If the applicant or their spouse has traded, given, or sold any resources in the last 60 months, those transfers must be detailed under Transfers. Otherwise, they can check the box to indicate no transfers. The legal issues page is for legal issues regarding the applicant or the spouse. These would include pending legal claims and money that is owed to them. Click Save and Next. The health plan page is where the applicant selects the health plan they want from the choices provided. All applicants must choose a health plan. The county is pre-filled based on the address from the contact information address page. Currently, most health plans are located in all counties. WellCare is pending expanding to all counties. The drop-down box will only show the health plans available in the county where the person lives at the time they apply. The attachments page allows the applicant to upload documents with their application. Specific documents requested, such as the completed designation of authorized representative form, may appear depending on how the applicant answered certain questions on the previous pages. This is the window to upload attachments. Click Browse. Browse allows the applicant to search for documents that are on their computer. A new window appears so the applicant can navigate to the file on their computer, select it, and click Open. The file location appears after Attach File. The applicant must type a description of their file, then click Save Attachment. Be sure to type in the name of the document attached so that it is labeled when it uploads. In this example, it's labeled Birth Certificate. The Uploaded Successfully message alerts the applicant that their document was uploaded to their application. When they are finished uploading documents, they click Close in the upper right corner and the attachment window will close. Or they could use Save Attachment and save more documents. When the attachment window is closed, the attachment page will refresh and show the attachments the applicant uploaded. They can add more by clicking Upload Attachment. The review page is a feature of the online application. The applicant can click the plus sign to expand the section to review that information and click the minus sign to close that section. If they need to change any information, they can click Edit next to that section heading and the application will take them to that page. Another way to go back to the previous page of the application is to click on that section in the navigation menu found on the left side of the page. The applicant should review all sections to be sure the information they have entered is correct. This is very important. This is the top of the Rights and Responsibilities page. The applicant should read and review each statement on this page so that they know what they will be electronically signing. The applicant should be aware that they must tell the EDA if anything changes from what they put on this application. This is the rest of the Rights and Responsibilities page. The applicant needs to check the box to indicate they have read and that they agree with the statements listed above. Click Submit Application. The confirmation page shows the application was submitted successfully to the eligibility determining agency, and is, in this example, it's Mercer County Board of Social Services. This page also contains the address and phone number for the agency so the applicant can follow up on their application. The applicant should print this page for their records. They can use the information if they need help or have any questions about their application. The applicant can print a copy of their application by clicking Print Review Page. Remember, successful submission does not guarantee eligibility. The applicant cannot change any of the information on the application, but they can still go back and upload more attachments. This is what the printed confirmation page looks like. The applicant could print this page for their records. This page is also automatically added to their account. It says, do not submit another application while this one is being processed. This is what the printed review page looks like. The applicant could print the application for their records. However, a copy of the application will also be in the applicant's online account, and they can view it when they log in. Thank you for your interest in this training. Have a good day.